Let's look more closely at these factor variables. For now, I want to draw your attention to the age.range variable right here. Notice that it says that we have a factor variable with 7 different levels. We can examine the levels of a variable by typing in the command levels and then putting in the variable right here. In the console, we can see the 7 levels of the age.range variable. Now, instead of creating a table of the age.range variable, let's create a plot that shows how many users are in each bin. That is, we want to figure out how many survey respondents are between the ages of 18 and 24, 25 and 34, and so on. I'm going to create this plot using the ggplot2 package and the qplot function that comes with it. Again, don't worry about understanding this code too much. We'll have practice with this in the next lesson. When I run this code, I get my plot over here. Zooming in on this plot, I want you to notice that the age groups appear to be in order. This is true for everyone except the survey takers who are under the age of 18. Now, it would be really helpful if this bar was really oriented over here. That way, we could make comparisons across the groups more easily. Now, this is why we would want to have ordered factors. The variable age.range just contains factors with 7 levels, but these levels aren't arranged in any particular order. Sometimes we want to introduce order into our dataset, so that way we can make more readable plots. So, knowing a little bit about ordered factors, let's see if you can answer this next question. If you haven't already done so, download the Reddit survey data and look at its structure. After you looked at the structure of the variables, try and answer this question: which of these variables in the dataset could also be converted to an ordered factor, just like age.range? Check any of the variables that apply.